Hello everyone. Today we have with us Vivek sir. So today's day and age, digital presence is extremely important.
Right.
Why is that so? How does it help any business? Let's say be it a startup, be it an already existing business. Why is it important for them to be present digitally?
Okay. See, with the changing trends, I think digital presence to begin with has become the name and address of your business.
Mm-hmm.
So just to give you again a couple of examples, a very traditional guy was coming to meet me and I was not very sure that he is on digital medium. And he was coming to my home and the guy said, Vivek, please send me your location.
Mm-hmm.
Basic Google Map location, which you send through WhatsApp.
Pin location.
Right. So that what I say is the basic digital presence. That people, when they're going to meet each other personally, forget about businesses, they expect that you are able to comfortably send them the location. Because as society keeps changing, people don't want to ask the local guys. So GPRS is actually coming into action.
Mm-hmm.
Now that is what I call basic digital presence, which is a basic Google listing. So even the most small traditional business, which is your locality small restaurant or a locality cloth shop or a locality doctor, right? So if you are going for a local dentist or a local mm-hmm. thing, they are expecting, the customers are expecting that at least you should have a web presence so that I am able to find your place comfortably. So I can open my Google Map and I can reach your location, etc. Similarly, when you go slightly up market, I would be happy as a customer if I'm able to check variety as well as prices before I come to a place. So if you are a small restaurant, you have an online presence with your menu and your variety. I know beforehand, before coming to a place, that what can I expect? Which has been the reason for the success of Zomato, Swiggy and many other players.
Yes.
Again, I'm talking about basic digital presence, where you're not getting customers from digital, but your presence is required there only to survive your offline business. Take the case of large electronic stores like Vijay Sales and Croma. They have presence, they have huge presence. Their core DNA is to sell offline. That's why they are maintaining such high stores. But still they are present digitally. They are present solidly in non-digital. Their website is very, very good. They are able to give you entire variety in prices and availability at their stores. This is my perception that maybe still they are not wishing to sell digitally, but digital has become a very important medium for them to take customers to their offline stores, right? So these are the hardcore offline businesses. Then because of, especially in the case of India and coming of GST, now the state boundaries is completely vanished, okay? Completely vanished. Because you have standard GST, there are no state taxes. So if I am a customer in Delhi and I get X thing from my market and I get the same thing which is 400 kilometers away and including transportation, my net cost is small, I'll buy from that guy, right? So now digital has also, you know, diminished the boundaries, especially in the case of India. The state boundary has been completely gone with the advent of GST and digital, combining both. So now if you are a manufacturer, if you are a small and medium enterprise, if you are a big trade, small to medium trader, and you are wondering that why your business is not going to next level, the reason is very simple. Because somebody else who is more digitally present is taking your business away. So having your listing on the digital portals like Flipkart, Amazon, IndiaMart is an example of being present digitally, right? I can give you tons of examples of businesses which are surviving through these guys, but these guys have their own limitations. And should I say these guys have their own whims and fancies as well as their own choices. They will not be fair to you every time unless until you are present personally, because they will try to sell products of people with which they get more profit, right?
Yes.
So you are selling yourself to a bigger platform where you are competing with other people also, right? So while doing it, it's very important that you slowly and steadily create your own presence. That's why I said changing trends, it is fine to sell on Flipkart, Amazon, IndiaMart, Trade India, etc., etc., but you need to have equally strong digital presence for yourself.
Mm-hmm.
This is for businesses are concerned. Take example of schools. Mm-hmm. Now, because of few instances which happened across India, and just to again share a very personal example, finally, you know, my kid's school, which they studied in one of the DPS branches in Delhi, they have finally started this technology of automated SMSs to parents when the kid mm-hmm. enters or leaves the school,
mm-hmm.
as well as we can check the location of the kid anytime. Now, these things are slowly become not luxuries, a basic expectations.
Yes.
So, if you are running a school,
mm-hmm.
you need to have this technology in place because parents are expecting it.
Mm-hmm.
So, digital doesn't mean only website. Digital, when I say digital, it means you need to use digital technology,
uh-huh.
which can be web presence, social presence, Google presence, as well as hardcore technologies like ERP for your business. You have to provide them. There is mm-hmm.
no way out.
If you want to survive in competition,
mm-hmm.
because the customers are expecting the same.
Mm-hmm.
They want this service.
So, sir, how can these small or medium businesses wanting to have a digital presence come online? I mean, who should they approach? Where should they go to get the right guidance to come online and have a good digital presence?
Right. Once again, Garima, the way I always put it, there can be three kind of businesses, and these are rough estimates. So let's say somebody whose annual revenues, which you call turnover, is less than $100,000, or in rupees terms, 70 lakh rupees in current rupee dollar term.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe a basic website which was created by a local vendor, which you ads which you see on the pillars, that 5,000 rupees in your website banwaye,
yes.
would be a good guy to serve your purpose. On the other hand, I'm sure if you are a company with turnover over 100 crores,
mm-hmm.
which you know should be like 20 million, 15 million dollars, you must be having your in-house technical team. There would be a good chief technology officer with 3 or 5, 6 team members, and together they shall be managing your technology. Digital, hardcore technology, whatever you want to say it. The real problem very frankly happens with people in between.
Mm-hmm.
People whose turnover are between, let's say, 1 crore to 100, 150 crore or 200 crore. In dollars term, $100,000 to $20 million. They cannot afford the in-house great team. And sadly, they tend to fall in the trap of those cheap, low-cost vendors,
mm-hmm.
which are not capable and suitable to create solutions for them.
Mm-hmm.
Because their expertise is only to know a software, to create a 6-page website, that's it. But they cannot even understand your business.
Uh-huh.
To give you a business solution,
hmm.
to give you a digital solution,
hmm.
they can give you a website, they can give you a Facebook page, they can give you an Instagram page, Twitter page, and YouTube page, and all that. But can they plan digital solution for you?
Hmm.
No. So at this moment, I always tell people that you need a captain who is intelligent enough, technologically as well as business wise, who can create solution for you and deliver that solution for you. That guy would be surely expensive than the low cost roadside vendors
yes,
or
yes.
website to begin with. But on a long term, it would be cheaper than the in-house team to begin
mm-hmm.
with, because in-house team will have a fixed cost from day one, which is for the bigger companies. So you can take a right technology provider or solution provider, should I say, a team who understands both technology as well as business, so that they give you a solution which gives you a right base. Now, on the right base, as you grow and when you develop, when you hire your in-house team, see, hiring an in-house team is definitely going to happen,
uh-huh.
but that can have to happen after 2 years when you've reached that level of revenue. But if your base is right, if your base is developed and conceptualized by the right people,
mm-hmm.
then when this great in-house team will come,
yes.
this work will be of use.
Yeah.
So hire the right vendor. Of course, McKinsey, BCG, KPMG kind of vendors are also there, but they are very expensive and
yes.
they tend to work for people who are already multi-billion dollar companies.
Mm-hmm.
So middle level vendors. And I'm sure that if you go to digital space, you will find people with right teams, with right management structure, management teams, who have this background, this ability, this capability to develop these solutions for you.
Hmm.
So look for these people, spend enough money to begin with, create a right base of digital solution for your enterprise,
hmm,
and then move forward.
Thank you so much for your insights, sir.
My pleasure, my pleasure.
Thank you for watching, everybody.